When working on your Appian application, chances are you'll come across situations where you need to reference user data. For example, you might need to sort a grid by last name or display a user's email in an interface. Now, it's easier than ever to leverage user data with the user record type. In this video, you'll learn what the user record type is and how to use it. The user record type is an out-of-the-box record type available in each Appian environment. It contains a directory of users, active and inactive, and it's often used as a corporate directory. It's important because it provides a quick and easy way to reference and view user data throughout your applications. And with low-code data modeling capabilities, you can easily connect this user information with your business data and transform it into the insights you need. To find the design object in Appian Designer, instead of clicking on an application, go to Objects. Select a record type, then find the one named User. If needed, you can also rename it. Once in the record type, if you're prompted, you should update the user record type to leverage data sync and the latest low-code features. For more information about this process, review Appian documentation. Importantly, data sync allows you to use record type relationships, which you can use to reference user data from your related business data, and configure record level security, which allows you to determine who can see what data. Under Data Model, you can see that the record type has default fields that capture standard information, like name, address, title, and supervisor. You cannot edit or remove these, but you can create custom record fields that fit your business needs. For example, you could use an aggregation to count the number of direct reports a user has. Generally, you can use the user record type like other record types, so you can make other changes including modifying the record list, user filters, record views, and record actions. Notice that there is already a default user filter and a summary view. In your apps, you'll most often use the user record type as a related record type. This way, you can directly access your user data from within your business record types. For example, you can reference it throughout your app to display user information in queries, interfaces, and reports. Now, let's take a look at an example of how to set up a relationship between a business record type and the user record type. I'll do this in the context of Acme Automobile, a commercial vehicle fleet. In my app, I have a record type called Vehicle that contains the vehicles in the fleet. In the record list, I want a column with the supervisor of the employee who added the vehicle. And more generally, I want to be able to reference user data about that employee throughout my app. This data is stored in the user record type. In the vehicle record type, I'll add a many-to-one relationship with the user record type. Under Common Fields, from Vehicle, I'll select the Added By field, which is a user data type, and from User, the Username field. This way, I can reference the user data about the person who added the vehicle. Now, I can go to List to add the new column. I'll call it Supervisor, and use the new relationship to reference the user record type and get the supervisor data. I'll choose the first and last name field so the name is formatted how I want. It's also easy to sort grids by user data, so I can use the same field under Sort field. Now, let's take a look at the record list. As you can see, it contains a new column with the supervisor's full name, and I can sort accordingly. It's as simple as that, and there's no need for complex functions or duplicating data. As I continue building my app, I will be able to leverage this relationship in other places, like my interfaces and reports. To learn more about working with data in Appian, visit us at Academy Online, and you can get a free Appian Community Edition environment to try it out yourself. Thank you for watching, and happy learning.